Our Joggles Creative Surface offerings continue to grow with the addition of the subject of today's video. Named Wet Cement, this cool, neutral gray paper is heavy enough to hold up to wet media and is absorbent. Sprays and paints love this surface and it loves them back with the gray color, making just about every other look marvelous. In today's video, I'll show you Wet Cement and the styles of disc-bound pages and tags it's available in, plus a couple of techniques for adding color to the background. Links to the products can be found down below. The gray color of wet cement is going to influence and flavor what you put on top of it. Now I wanted to show off some of the paper color along with whatever the media was, so you can see that in some places there is a lot of wet cement showing and in others there's less, especially here. And I used a whole bunch of different kind of media. So sprays, very obviously. I put some paint on a gel press plate. I applied paint with a brayer. I applied paint with my fingers. You can run this stuff, it looks great, through an embossing folder. Even things like Pixie Sparkles and the Cosmic Shimmer iridescent watercolors, and we'll get to these in the next segment. These all look really great on the gray. So I have some other samples to show you before I get started with techniques, because I want you to see how versatile this stuff is, and it is in fact very versatile. So I brought out some of the new Crypt Distress Grit Paint, which is part of the 2022 Halloween release from Tim. And now this one looks a little less like grit paste, but if I hold this up, you can really see it. But what happened here, and I used some of the new Halloween 2022 mica stains, that's what you see coloring the grit paste. So if I hold this up, you can see that the color that's underneath has been picked up because, of course, distress reactivates. I also used it here, and because I used it on paint, it didn't pick up any of the underlying color, and that's the same thing here. Again, none of the underlying color has been influenced or has a chance to influence it because it's permanent when it's dry. And you can see the speckles that are in there because that's the nature of the grit paste. So I have some samples that I wanted to show you. Here I embossed and I used some foundry wax on top, heated it up, and just fun ways that you can create things like the Crafter's Workshop, the sticky when dry medium, and some foil. All of these things, anything that you want to do is pretty much going to work fine on wet cement. Okay, so I'm going to start with my go-to technique, which is going to be oxide sprays. And I've got a couple of colors, and I might bring in some purple, I haven't really decided yet. And what I'm going to do to have some fun is I'm going to bring in the mica stains. Now these might have Halloween names, but as far as I'm concerned, purple is purple and green is green, and I'm happy to use them year round. So the process here, since I'm going to use purple and green, let's bring in, so I have shaded lilac, peacock feathers, and some cracked pistachio, and in this mica stains I have Wicked Elixir and Fortune Teller. So the process here, I'm going to give these a little bit of a shake. The process, as always, is to go ahead and spritz your color down. Now, obviously, green and purple would ordinarily make a mess, but this dip and dab technique, which is really just a takeoff of Tim's Distress Wrinkle-Free technique, works really well, and you don't have to necessarily really mix all of this stuff up. All right, I'm going to put some of the green in these areas. And I'm going to grab, I have a probably more than I need here. I actually want to put a little bit of water on this too. So I have a 4x4 disc bound page that I'm just going to start dipping and dabbing. Ooh, how pretty is that? Let's put some of that up there. All right, that looks fine the way that it is. Go ahead and dip and dab. And obviously I can have, oh, that's so pretty. I can have this be more purple or more green depending on where I tap this. So if I come up here, you can see that this initial layer is far more purple. So let me take a second and dry these because they always look better when you come back and put another layer on. And then I will finish the dip and dab and we'll move on to the next. All right, with these first layers dry, I'm going to come back and I'm going to dip and dab and add some more just to finish these tags off. Now sometimes, you know, less is more and sometimes more is more, and when I'm working with sparkly stuff, for me, oftentimes more is more because that's what I love. So you really are not going to be able to see the shimmer from the mica sprays or mica stains in here because they're wet and it's just a little harder to see. So let me put these to one side and let me come in and wipe this up. And just go ahead and give this a mist of water. And then I will bring in a tag that I did previously that's already dry so that you can see what this looks like. So I'm almost positive, because I did these a couple of days ago, that I used the mica stain that's named, this one is Harvest Moon, you can see it's yellow. I'm pretty certain that that's what I used here. I might have used some of the green too, the one that is named, that I just used, that's named Wicked Elixir, but I honestly don't remember. But if I hold this up, you can see the shimmer from the mica stain in there. And this, again, more is more for me. I like oxide sprays. They're one of my go-to products, but when you add something like this, they really get to be fun. Before I forget, the oxide sprays are on sale at 25% off. We have ample stock of the new 2022 Distress mica stains. And we are also still in the midst of a giveaway where for every $15 you spend, we'll give you, on products other than gift certificates, we'll give you a tube of Amsterdam acrylic, the little 20 mil tubes that are so much fun. Okay, so coming back to oxide sprays for a second. Obviously, every bottle has a spray head and a pickup tube inside. So I thought, well, all right, let's try something a little bit different. And that's exactly what I did. So you can see here, all I did was lay out some color and then just scratch it back and forth to kind of make this central area. I'm going to show you how to do these in 1 second. Again, kind of a fun thing. Creates this burst. Here's a finished piece that's that way. And then this is just taking the, well, I can quickly show you. This is just taking the pickup tube and doing this. Whoops, sorry, that wasn't in the frame. It's taking the pickup tube and doing this, so super easy. But what I am going to show you is how to do what I think of as these starburst kind of things. All right, so let's get these out of the way and starburst. So super easy to do. I've got a tag here. Well, you know what? Let's grab a 4x4 page, because you can certainly do it on any of these. What I'm going to do is I'm going to pick a spray color, and then I'm going to put another color on top of it. Now, I want there to be contrast so that you can see it. Here I used one of the mica stains. Here I just went and used two colors of oxide sprays. So my tool of choice is a knitting needle. You can use the back end of a paintbrush. If you have a skewer, you can use one of those. You could probably use a toothpick, but I think the tip is too fine. Plus, they're short, and they're a little harder to handle. So let's go ahead and let's pick a couple of colors where there's plenty of contrast. Let's see what I got here. All right, so I have peacock feathers and milled lavender. So I'm going to put a spritz of peacock feathers down, and then I'm going to put milled, well, that's not going to work. So let's try that again. That was too big a spritz, because sometimes you can plan and things don't go exactly your way. So you know what? Let's come in and use Chip Sapphire. I'm going to give this a shake. I'm going to put down some Chip Sapphire, and then I'm going to put some of this, let's try putting this milled lavender on top. But this time I want a smaller spray. Well, I need enough here so it'll show. Okay, so now, it's a really a simple matter. All I'm going to do is start pulling the color out to create this starburst effect. Now, with that said, these lines will continue to move, as you can see, until the sprays are dry. So you can do one of two things. You can keep playing with it until the sprays are dry. Or if you really want to cement that initial pattern in, you bring in your heat tool and you hold it with one hand and your fingers while you continue to do this. Whoops. Now I have a fair amount of liquid on here, so it's going to take a little bit longer to dry. But as long as I continue to do this, some of the original ones are obviously long since gone, but I'm getting all of these burst effects in other places, and I'm really okay with that. And if I wanted to come back and I wanted to add more, I could certainly do that as well. All right, so you can see that I've got more of the burst coming out over here than I do over here, but if I hold this up, you can still see that pattern on there. Now, trying to do something on camera sometimes is not always as easy. Here, I put down the two colors, and I immediately, first of all, there was less liquid, and I immediately flicked through them to create the spokes, and then I started to heat right away, and that is really what lets me capture that. Now, with the mica stains, it's a little bit different. You can see the burst in the center looks shimmery because of the mica in the mica stain, but it also starts to affect what's out here as you pull those colors out. So here I have some of those longer tendrils that are shimmery. So up next, I'm going to bring in a couple of Cosmic Shimmer products. I've got Pixie Sparkles, and I've got their iridescent watercolor palettes, and I'm going to show you how awesome the sparkly stuff looks on wet cement. Cosmic Shimmer Pixie Sparkles and the iridescent watercolors offer a shimmer effect that I think looks really nice on wet cement, though the end result is going to be pretty different. So these are both Pixie Sparkles, and you can see how much they reflect because the mica particles are much larger in that than they are in the iridescent watercolors. This produces a far more pearly effect. So I'm going to work, what have I got here? I have a number 8 tag that I'm going to go ahead and use Pixie Sparkles on. Now, when you do this, you can choose to make the surface wet and then add Pixie Sparkles, or you can put the powder down and add water, and that's what I'm going to do. So I'm going to just start by putting some powder down. That's probably enough. And then I'll go ahead with this purple color. Now, with Pixie Sparkles, it depends on what color they are. What you see in the bottle might not be the color that ultimately blooms when you add water, because dye powders can have a tendency to look very different in their dry form than they do in the wet. So all I'm going to do is just lightly mist this, and that's as far as I want to go. I like this kind of raggedy, jaggedy look that's going on here. If I wanted smooth, I could put a lot more water on here and let the colors blend, but that's not the end result I'm looking for. And that's the process that I used. Let's wipe up the water. That's the process that I use on this page. These are the identical colors, and again, I went with less water after I added the powder so that I would get this less blended look, and again, lots of shimmer on there. So the thing to know too is when you get through with the water, if you can feel a little bit of powder on there, this is almost dry, you can just brush the excess powder off, and then it's kind of not in your way. Because some of it, unless you really flood it, some of it won't completely dissolve. Okay, so this is one of the palettes of the Cosmic Shimmer Iridescent Watercolors, and you can see that it's wet. Because these are dry cakes, I went ahead and I misted them with water first so that they would begin to activate. Let's go ahead, let's grab a 4x4 page because it's the easiest thing I can put my hand on. So I've got some plain water and a brush, and what I'm going to do for this method, I'm going to put some water down first. Unlike the other one where I put the color down first, this time I'm going to add a little bit of water. I don't want to flood it, but this will help kind of guide where the color goes, and it'll also help blend the color. So that's fine. Let's go ahead and grab, well, let's grab some of this pinky purple because it's pretty. And I'm just going to touch this on here, and the water that's already on the surface is going to help this color wick out so that it spreads and it will blend when I add another. If I think that I need a little bit of water, I can just come in and I can dunk my brush in some clean water. All right, so that looks good. Let's just rinse this out. And then let's go ahead and grab some of this. If I bring this back in, I'm going to grab some of this teal color. Now this is kind of a gray teal, so it'll probably look, oh, it does. It's actually more of a green color. It looks really cool on the gray surface. Just go ahead and put a little bit over here. And then the last color that I think I'm going to add, I'm going to come in, let's just rinse this off, and I'm going to come in and grab some of this. Let's grab some of this dark blue. So there's the dark blue. And now again, I'm just going to come and I can touch it in the center of one of the other colors if I want to get a little bit more bleeding going on and a little bit more color blending going on. Now I just wet my brush and that's helping these colors move around. So one of the things that I can see is I didn't put enough of this green on, so I'm going to pick up some more because it's pretty translucent in spots and I do want to see more of the green. So I'll just come back and add more wherever I think it needs it. But, you know, I like working like this. I think it's fun to let the water and the color kind of do their magic on their own. You don't have to do a whole heck of a lot when you work this way because you've got the water that's kind of doing part of the work for you. So this is Wet Cement, the newest joggle surface available in disc-bound journals, additional pages, and in 4 sizes of tags.